Dear students, now we'll start with the topic of satellite motion. All of you are aware about satellite or bodies or heavenly bodies moving around a planet. And in case of satellite motion, one any body which moves around a planet in some orbit, we can say the simplest motion is a body of mass which revolves around a planet in a circular orbit. And say if there is a planet and a body of mass is moving with such a speed that it is revolving in an orbit of radius r. So we can simply state here the gravitational force acting on the body due to the gravity of planet will provide the necessary centripetal force for its circular motion. And such kind of bodies which revolve around a planet are called satellites. And we can simply state for a circular orbit, satellite motion, we must use gmm by r square as to be equals to mv square by r. Here m is the mass of planet, small m is the mass of a body or satellite which is revolving around the planet. And here the gravitational force acting on the body, if provide the necessary centripetal force, it will continue to move in a stable circular orbit. Here this r and m gets cancelled out and the speed of the satellite can be written as root of gm by r, which is the most simple and the standard relation of orbital speed in circular orbit of radius r. Whenever a body is to revolve round a circular orbit of radius r in the surrounding of a planet, its velocity should be given as root of gm by r. And here you can also write on a note which we can see in this expression that orbital speed of a satellite does not depend on mass of satellite. Here, whether the satellite is heavy or light, it won't make any difference. If it is to revolve in an orbit of radius r, its speed is given by root of gm by r. It depends on the orbital radius as well as the mass of the planet around which it is revolving. It does not depend on the mass of satellite. So, in sequence, we calculate the orbital period of a satellite in circular orbit. Say if the satellite of mass m is revolving around a planet in an orbital radius r, say its orbital speed is v, then we already calculated in the previous sheet that orbital speed of satellite we can write as v is equals to root of gm by r. It does not depend on the mass of satellite. So here we calculate the time period of a revolution of satellite, and this time period we can simply write as 2 pi r by v, as the orbit length is 2 pi r and it is revolving at a speed v. So we substitute the values, then t can be written as 2 pi r by speed, we can write as root of gm by r. Then in this situation we can see the value of time period, we can write as 2 pi by root of gm. If this root r can be taken up, it will be r to power 3 by 2. This is quite useful to understand. And always remember that the time period of revolution of a satellite is directly proportional to 3 by 2 power of the orbital radius and 1 by 2 power of the mass of the planet. So just keep it in mind. Now we are going to study in coming sections about various characteristics related to satellite motion, like energy of satellite and the change of its orbit and many other situations.